Hello everyone, my name is Ever Barbero, and today I'd like to talk about example 10.1 in my textbook, Finite Element Analysis of Composite Materials Using Abacus. In example 10.1, we demonstrate how to use cohesive zone elements, CZM, to simulate a double cantilever beam consisting of two laminas bonded by a thin adhesive. First, set the work directory. Now import a template model, by executing a Python script, which you can download from my website, or fetch from the Abacus documentation. The script generates two models. We are not using this one, but this one, for the adhesive. And this part, for the beam. And once we put all parts together into an assembly, we get this 2D model, with these dimensions. Now create a material for the cohesive adhesive. Type traction. Here is the list of all the properties, as explained in the textbook. Now select the damage separation law, quads damage. With the parameters shown here, and explained in the textbook. Now add sub-options, damage evolution criterion, type, energy, mixed mode behavior, BK. With the parameters shown here, and explained in the textbook. Now create a section for the adhesive. The out-of-plane thickness, is the width of the beam. Assign the adhesive section to the adhesive part. Create a step, after step initial, with nonlinear geometry effect, on. Edit the field output request to include the status variable. Add another history output request, to monitor the set named, top. And here it is, the set named, top. First we mesh the beam. Plane strain, because the beam is 20 millimeters wide, quite wide, compared to the 2 millimeter thickness. Elements, 4 millimeters each. Now we mesh the adhesive. Thank you. cohesive elements for the adhesive. Elements, to match the beam elements, one by one. And here is the mesh, of the whole assembly. Now we use tie constraints, to attach the top layer's bottom surface, top, to the adhesive's top surface, co-top. Now we use tie constraints again, to attach the bottom layer's top surface, bot, to the adhesive's bottom surface, co-bot. Left of the adhesive, the two layers are disconnected. Now we apply a displacement to the tip of the top layer. Now we apply a downward displacement to the tip of the bottom layer. Note what model we pick, to create the job. In results, we can see that, at the end of the analysis, the two layers are separated, beyond the initial length of the debonded region. Let's see the animated time history. Now we can plot the reaction force, where the displacement is applied, versus the opening displacement U2. Now we operate on XY data, to plot, reaction force, versus opening displacement. Okay, that's it for today. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe. You can find more details in the textbook. by following the link in the description. Thank you.